So this is the tracing which everyone has to face in the EP lab. So what do we see? Not only the surface ECGs, but also the intracardiac ECGs as well. So over here, let me try to help you out. So these letters, they stand for His bundle ECG recordings. So these are from a quartic polar catheter, which has been kept in the His bundle region. And then this is the right atrium deflection.
Excuse me.
Niklesh?
Yes, yes.
So in the meantime, as I was trying to tell, like, we will try to walk through. So this is the decapolar lead, which has been kept in the coronary sinus. And how do we again further confirm that this is in the coronary sinuses? Anyone? I think there are a few people who have already assisted me in the EP. I see some few familiar faces. Come on, Kamlesh, and let's give it a try. So what do we notice over here? This is a big A. Why is it A? Because we try to correlate with the surface ECG leads. This is always the backbone, okay? So when we try to correlate with the surface ECG, so this is falling away, right? So this is the V. So this is, on this coronary sinus lead, what we notice is, this is a big A, small V, isn't it? So that's how we confirm, and of course, you can always go to the fluoro. You can see, is it in the coronary sinus itself or is it somewhere else? So what do we notice over here? If you try to look carefully in the lead V1, the three leads which is available over here, what do we notice? So this is, of course, left bundle branch block. And then what else do we see? Even in EP as well, if you try to get a tracing, intracardiac tracing, you should go step by step. So what else later on we see? But after that as well, we try to see is the distance between V and the A is really long. So what do we call it as a long VA tachycardia? So there is a lot of differential diagnosis as well for long VA tachycardia. One of the most common one, what we call it as accessory pathway. Okay, so this is what is AVRT. There are other mechanisms as well, but I don't want to really make it complicated. So what do we notice in this ECG actually? So same thing, same principle applies again over here. So these are the surface ECGs, 1, 2, 3, AVF, V1, V6. So what do we again notice over here? So V1 is positive or negative? Positive or negative? Simple principle. So this is positive, right? So this is right bundle branch block, isn't it? Then we try to look in the intracardiac ECGs as well. This is a little bit really complex one, but maybe hopefully in the future we'll try to decipher it altogether. So now we definitely know if there is a patient with accessory pathway, they may have a wide QRS tachycardia. Why am I calling may have? Because there are two types of accessory pathway mediated tachycardias. One can be orthodromic, one can be antidromic as well. So that is what is referring to as manifest versus concealed. Concealed accessory pathway, later on, when you do the surface ECG, it will be looking almost normal, so absolutely normal. So you may even think like that, okay, there's nothing at all. But yeah, when you start doing your procedures, otherwise, that is the time when you will start noticing the long VA tachycardia, and when you are going to do further pacing maneuvers, you will start seeing it is accessory pathway. So this is another classical ECG, surface ECG, okay? Surface ECG, in which we notice, what do we see over here? What do we see over here? Exactly, wonderful, delta waves. And what else do we see? So there is one prize for the best audience participation as well. I'm looking at everyone. So what else do we see? Wonderful. And? Something shocking. Some shocking is happening, right? Wonderful. Good. We have a very smart audience. So what about this? In this as well, we'll try to give a little bit hint. Little bit. As I said, let's not try to go deep, otherwise we'll lose the fun. So what is happening over here in this ECG? Similarly, as I said, always try to look for example, is there a bundle branch block pattern over here? So for example, even over here, you see this. V1 is negative, right? And how about the V6? V6 is positive. So what kind of bundle branch block pattern it is?
Left.
Exactly. So if it is a left bundle branch block pattern, for the accessory pathways as well, they will be on the opposite side. If it is left, so it should be on the right side, isn't it? So after that, there are algorithms when you should try to see for the chess leads, in fact, if you want to localize it further. Okay. What is happening in this ECG actually? I don't try to give a lot of difficult ECGs. Let's try to make things simple. Life is already complex. Everyone has a lot of stress and all day-to-day life in the clinic as well. What is happening over here? What is it? So I think, okay, one more thing I want to really make it clear over here. AVRT was a little bit recent name which was proposed by the standard body. The standard body is NAPSE, or the Heart Rhythm Society. The NAPSE stands for North American Pacific Society of Cardiac Electrophysiology, actually. So AVRT means atrioventricular reentry tachycardia. So this was the scientific name which was proposed for the tachycardias which is utilizing the accessory pathways, in fact. So what is happening over here? So of course this is a tachycardia, right? Dr. Nirav taught us all wonderfully how to approach any ECG. We try to look for the rate, rhythm, then axis, then what else? So then you start seeing the intervals, how the segments, that's how you proceed, right? So for example, the rate was, definitely it is a tachycardia. I'm so sorry, it's not really clear. Maybe the projection or I don't know what it is. So rate wise tachycardia. Rhythm wise?
Sinus rhythm.
Wonderful. Then what do we need to see? Axis. So what do we see the axis? He gave such a simple clue. If one is positive, two is positive. Wonderful. So this is definitely not VT, right? Okay, there should be some minor things as well, but that's not too much complicated as well. See, one more thing I want to really tell, rare things are rarely correct. If you become a super specialist, yes, always remember about the rare things. But in the meantime, always remember it like this, the general common things as well. So definitely, this is a white cuirass tachycardia, regular with normal access. And then there are some indirect hints as well, which you should try to see. How to determine, is it a, yeah, you should try to see for the VA dissociation if it is present, if you can really see the P waves as well. Can you notice, that, it is a little bit difficult to say, but can you make out the P waves? What are the leads in which you will see the for the P waves actually?
V1.
Wonderful, and?
Second.
Wonderful. See, you have a very smart audience. Very smart. I really like it. So what do we notice over here? Do we notice any VA dissociation? Axis is definitely normal. Okay, some things we will leave for Ajay sir's class as well. During the quiz, we will try to brainstorm a lot of things as well. So if you try to see some of the other leads as well, you will start noticing there are some regular P waves, in fact. Okay, we'll try again. Yeah. Okay.
What is the volume?
Is it audible?
Yeah.
Okay, so then we'll disconnect from here. Okay, yeah.
Wrong.
And tachycardia can be the cardiomyopathy by LV dilatation or impaired LV function. Most of all, is the patient stable or not? So look at the airway breathing circulation parameters, look at the monitor, there should be a fresh start to that side. Is the QRS narrow or wide?